So we've installed the Samsung smart digital door lock on the middle door there, and at the front door here I've removed the locks they had originally because I didn't have the key. What I'm going to do now is install these patio bolts from Iconic. That goes in like that, quite nicely. Just so that's where I'm going to mark that. But on the left side, that bracket is too far back. There's no way I can push this back far enough to get that. So the option is to make a different bracket or just move this bracket up to here. If that will affect the door opening, I'm not sure, because it's really rather close there. So you're telling me you can't undo this shit? That's a fucking disaster. The screws only go one way. What the fuck? There's different. Where's the one? Look at this shit. That goes one way. You can't undo it. What the fuck? Now I have to get the fucking... Lucky I didn't go all the way in. I would have just ruined a perfectly good lock. Okay, so I got in with a bolt. Oh, now I feel like it's locked. Okay, unlocked. Just have a look at this. Yeah, so it's not going all the way. But what I can do is I can certainly drill a hole there, and then it will. So I'm going to do that because that seems like the easiest thing to do. Okay, so 10 millimeters in there. Ow, that drill bit's hot. It's in there. And I have to, I'm going to remove these screws and redo them. But that now goes all the way in, so I can use the same screw holes. And then that locks. So... that's one door. Well, not really. I'm going to do this now. I'm not proud of it. It's multicolored, but functionality-wise, one would hope. Yep, that's gone in all the way. Locked. Now you can't get in. I mean, you could try. You keep on knocking, but you can't get in. You keep on knocking, but you can't get in. Cheech and Chong, baby. Right? So that's one. That is one. Does this thing turn? No. So it looks pretty good, you know, it's not fucking Oh yeah, I forgot, I need to do one more hole here. Make sure that's straight. I'll just drill through there and do that. Okay, I just put one of those in. Everything functions as it should, which is nice. It's like it was meant to be there. Your turn. Just a little tiny fraction, just so that it's very comfortably fitting. Right now, it's very tight. But that's great. That's two doors done. So that's the install done. I mean, we used a number of different types of screws to get it done. This one was a lot neater. And that's on there. That's on there. This one uses two different screws, and this one has a number of different screws, and over here we've got a number of different screws again, but functionality wise it works, and let's just see an example of that. So once I go in here and lock the bus, the only way in will be through there. So we come in here. Or we are in here already, as an example. Close that, hang that in there, that's in. We can choose to lock it or not, depending on the dodgy area that we might be finding ourselves in. And this one just requires a bit more love just at the end there. So as you can see, just a little bit more love, and it's in. Just like that. Ow. So that one goes there. That one goes there, don't hit your head on that. So they're in, right? So no longer can you push this door open and open it. And from the other side you can't, there's no handle. And you can't push in from this side because the lock's there and the lock's there. So now we're in a bus. So it's a good install, I reckon. Again, a temporary measure, but a good one. Very cheap install, and then we get out of the bus, close the door, locks it, and then guess what? The only way in the bus is right there. How good's that? That was couple of hours work dawdling around. Want to get in? Can't get in. So cool. That's cool. There you go. All nice and locked up. Now that means I can leave my bouillons of gold, my gold bouillon all in here. And no one can get in there. So I'll just move all my gold and silver in, I guess. That is locked. Feel me, dog? Open. I just realized this screw could possibly cop a bit more in, just to be safe, on the safe side. And when I come into my home, that'll lock for me automatically. I can get naked as quick as possible without having to worry about locking the door, and I can just quickly jump into the shower or wherever else it is that I need to be. So there you go, the bus build is well on its way. What a great install. They look like they were always there. If I take the key out, they're just black with obviously that rod. Now, I think what's happening with these guys is, like, they're coming in into the bus, and there's a lot of toxic stuff going on. There's another one. And now this guy's probably going to die too, you know, because... So I'm going to open up the windows. But, yeah, they seem to be coming in here, and I did notice one of them, like, drank some toxic water. And then it was all over for him. That was outside, though. So I'm not sure. There's a nest around here. And they're probably upset because of those plants that used to be there. You know, they used to eat a lot off those plants. So, yeah, but they're in here every day. And I'm not sure. He's got a nest nearby. I just don't want him to make a nest of my bus, that's all. It will grab from this side, whoop, and this side, onto this bar. So again, these are the 2.4s. So I need, I think, like a 2.5 or 2.6 here. I will measure that properly. So from there, it will hold from the sides, but then I'll also cut up that metal bracket that I put there along here and pop rivet it some in along the way. To hold it up, particularly focusing most of the strength over here on the bed. I know that this part here is not going to be a bed, but while we're there, we may as well. So the advantages of that. So I've lined that up right there, and it comes, you won't be able to see it, I think, but it comes, this piece of wood comes just above this all the way along. So that's great, because it means it's going to keep it above that line. And so then, basically, if I put this back where it was, I figured this all out. So then I'll bring a piece of wood up to this level. So once it's all bolted together, you know, there won't be a bow here. Like, if you come and sleep on this side, it won't sort of flex. It won't, it's wood. There's that added support to make sure that it really, really freaking won't. In there very nicely, very nice. They fit in there real easy. So bows out a bit, this one. It bows out this way. As you can see, it comes out a little bit. Not much, because there's a little bit of a space that it pulls it out. But that's perfect for my needs. That'll keep everything straight. And then that's good there, with the plywood going on top. So I'm going to cut three more of those, and then I'm just going to space them out to where it needs to be. I'm not going to nail anything in yet. Then I'll cut this bar. Now I'll just measure that up. And hopefully I'll get 3 out of that, but I might have to cut that one up too, so I'll just get it with me while I'm here. Let's just go and measure. Let's put it together. Much new, but they're in there now. I mean, those are loose, so we can pretty much start putting all that together, and then once we've done that, bring in some boards. Sturdiest piece of woodwork that I've ever seen done by me. Okay, here's what we've got from the back so far. So these boards will go across and I'll just cut them, but first I've brought in these and I'm going to measure them to size, which is 26. Mark, I forgot. Yeah, I'm gonna have to measure it again. Fantastic. So I wrote it down this time. It's 2360. Alright, while you guys were fluffing about back there, I ran in and got some. I cut that wood to size, it's over there. So I'm gonna just saw them off. Okay, so the neighbor came over and just used the door and presented a fault with the handle being there. There's an issue because what happens is when you open the door, that there is the issue, is you hurt your hand there. So she actually did hurt her hand. So I feel very bad about that. So this is a emergency repair. So what I'm going to do is drill a hole out of this to a 10mm, and I can leave that one the same upstairs, but I'm basically just going to attach it there and then find the corresponding spot and attach it there, and that'll be the new door handle for the inside, and I guess the outside when you're out there. I may have to remove that handle in the end, so that's a big possibility I'm dealing with, because it does stick out, but I'm not sure how much I'm allowed for it to stick out. I know it's a little bit, so I think this should be okay, but I have to keep that in mind. So not using this handle, and I'm going to try and figure out a way to install this other one. Okay, that was did very easily. Got it did. It got did. Okay, that's the 10mm, and that's the whatever the hell that mill is. So, let's put it in. back on there, nice and sturdy. So that's the black handle's still on the outside. If that is an issue, we'll figure something out, but for now, that was a quick adjustment. So back to the bed frame. Here's what we've got going on. I've got lines on these. That's where they're going to be cut. Yesterday we tried all those. Today we've got these two. Alright, that one went straight in there. I'm not too sure about the hold, but if that's in there, then there's that much going out the other side. So, I mean, it's got to be a good hold, right? I'm going to try the other end, and then I'm just going to batten it down. And if that's as good as we're going to get it, then that's as good as we're going to get it. That is in, solid, and whether or not it's level is undetermined. So I'm going to spray this handle while I'm here. I'm just going to undo it. I know I should be doing the bed, but yeah. Left that off for the time being, but it's enough to see and test with the bed, so why not bring it in, right? It's like poetry. Me and the weird dog just managed to get that to there. On there. I left my thing on, so that's... What are you doing? Get back to work. That's what double beds do. You'll see that, you know, I don't know what other people are doing, but if I had turned that this way, if I had turned that this way, I wouldn't have that much room on the sides as like drawers. I'm thinking maybe it can remain as some sort of access. I dreamt that it was stairs, but that's not going to work. But being able to exit that way, I think, is important. So I'm going to keep that in mind, because otherwise, whoever's sleeping on that end is going to have to wake somebody up to get to a toilet. But if there's an access that way, then that won't be an issue. And I think that's going to be the solver of the problem there. I think that's probably why people don't do it that way. I'm single, so this is not an issue really for me. But it's going to be an issue for somebody eventually, I guess. And if this were to be sold, someone's going to want and, you know that they can get out that way. So head of the bed is over there, and you could just shift and go down that way.